Happy Monday, guys and gals. Hope you guys had a great weekend. All right, so we are gonna do a little carving today, make a little sawdust. You guys probably saw this on Friday. It's pre-Friday right now over here. So I'm hoping you guys saw this sign and saw our new template of the month for October, yep. What are we calling him?
It's a zombie.
Zombie. Okay, we're calling him Zombie. Okay, he looks kind of happy. Well, maybe all zombies are happy. I don't know. Anyway, all right, so here's what we got. We're going to get this thing laid out. I was going to go ahead and lay it out off camera, but I wanted to kind of go through how, when you've got a weird font like this, how I go about kind of checking myself. So even though this is kind of a strange font. We call it creepy font. If you were to, we have these available. They're not on the website. If you're interested in these layout letters, write Vicky an email, VickyWithDaveSigns@gmail.com. We already talked about that, I'm sure, on Friday night. But if you were to go look for this font, you would look for Bloodlust. That's the name of the font if you were going to look for it online to print them out. Anyway, there is, even though they're kind of wonky, there is a lot of straight lines that you can kind of go by to make sure they're straight up and down. On the A's, not so much, but what I go by on the A's is the straight line on the inside and the bottom. But those look like they're pretty much set up. Now, I'm doing this on an oak drawer front. And I don't use a lot of oak, so I didn't really trust it not to bleed. So I went ahead and put two coats of this clear. I had a couple of semi-gloss, and I like gloss better, but I had some semi-gloss that I needed to use up. So I just put a couple coats on real quick just to try to eliminate any bleeding, which I don't think there really would be anyway, but I didn't want to really trust it. Huh? No, I'll just flip this one over so we can save that one. I do have two of these. Actually, I've got more than two, but that wanted to fly on me a little bit there. It's a little difficult to do with these gloves on. I want to shake this up a little bit more. On a warm day like today, it must be pushing 100 degrees. The pressure inside these cans. And this is a pretty fast nozzle anyway. You really got to be careful when you spray these things. Obviously, I'm being careful because every time I spray, I'm like holding my breath. And of course, we got a little breeze that just came up. Yeah, see, that one wanted to move on me a little bit, the L. So now I'm going to turn this over. So what I did was I measured in and balanced it from side to side. I'm just eyeballing this top to bottom. I think I'll be okay there. Wow, a lot of pressure in this can. I moved it back. These are, these are inch and a half letters, inch and a half tall. That L moved on me again. I'm going to cut these outset. The zombies are going to be inset.
That moved again.
Yep. I think that's going to give me a pretty good line, though. I think I should be okay. Yeah, plenty good enough. So I'm going to cut these inset and I'm going to cut these outset. So we'll set up and we'll be right back. All right, so one thing I want to go over that I haven't talked about a lot lately, but when you're spraying in short spurts like that and it's a warm day, sometimes this primer, or if you're using ink, comes out almost dry. So I can feel the surface of this, and I can feel that it has kind of a rough texture to it. So I'm just going to kind of try and get rid of that rough texture. any residue from that black spray. That dulled my lines a little bit, but not to the point where I can't tell what I'm carving. So I'm gonna keep this good one right in front of me so I can see where all those little lines are. Okay, I've got the bit set at about just shy of an eighth of an inch. Excuse me. This is the carving liner. And there's some really, really tight areas in here. So I'm gonna do all the detail with that. And then I'll go back in the meat inside. I'll do that with a profile bit. But I've got it set at almost an eighth of an inch. I might have to adjust that as I go, and you guys will see. I'll let you know. All right, lights. Here we go. Where's the switch on this thing? Oh, wait a minute. I need my cheaters. Almost messed up right there. I knew there was something I was forgetting. Ooh, that's better. I can see. About doing something like this, guys, is that if those lines are just somewhere close, you're okay. Like I think that in this area right here, it was a little sketchy, so I think I probably wasn't right on the line there, but doesn't matter. The overall idea is there. I think that's gonna work. So I'm gonna go ahead and move to the other end, do that off camera, then when we come back, we'll make a second cut on this. All right, so we have got the detail work done in there. Now I'm with the profile bit. I got it set at about 3/16. I think that's gonna be about right. I had to readjust the depth on this because it was eighth of an inch was too much. I had to back it off. Anyway, all right, so let's get the lights going here. That's actually the wrong way. There. All right, here we go. Thank you. Well, I had to back that off a little bit. It was a little too deep to begin with. I backed it off a little bit. I'm not sure to where. I think it's more than an eighth. Yeah, it's just a little over an eighth. But that gave me the width that I wanted. I'll need to brush that real good. So I'm going to go ahead and do the other zombie off camera. Then I'll come back. And I think these are tight enough areas. I want to use a 60 degree to take to do the background in here. So we'll be right back. Okay, so I've got the 60 degree in my little cordless DeWalt. And I'm about 3/16. I think that's going to be about right. I just want to take all of this stuff in there. Normally I would do that with a 90, but some pretty tight areas. The 60 will fit a little bit better, I think. So let's get after it. You guys noticed that when I turned the router around, how much sawdust was coming back at you guys just before I, that was on the other one. Before I did that, the sawdust was all flying at me. That goes right along to my theory that sometimes it flies out more one side than the other. And this thing, actually, the holes are not that much difference in size. It's just the way it works sometimes. Anyway, okay, so now what I have to do is just have to make sure that all my background is down below the surface so I don't end up with a bunch of white spots. So I'm gonna do that, brush that real good. We're gonna come back and do outside letters. All right, guys, I got the profile bit and I have got it set at about an eighth of an inch, something like that. I think that's gonna be about right. Let's get these outside letters done. being as those are some pretty tight lines, I'm going to set deeper and I'm going to go all the way around them again to give myself a little bit more room. But I think what I'm going to do, this stuff is so hard, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to sharpen my bit first. It feels like it's a little dull. It's been a while since I sharpened it. So we'll come back and we'll do a heavier line around there. All right, so we are back with the profile bit. I got it nice and sharp, I think. And I'm just going to go all the way around these letters to give myself a little bit more room so I don't have to get so close with my 90 when I'm doing the background. Here we go. So now I've got the 90 degree bit in, and I got it set at just shy of a quarter inch. I think that'll be about right. Now what I'm going to do here, I'm not going to do my standard cloud. Literally, I'm just going to kind of do a box all the way around everything using the letters and just kind of making a square, or I guess two rectangle boxes, one on top of another. At least that's what I'm going to attempt. Here we go. Thank you. that stuff is hard. All right. Guys, I'm gonna brush the heck out of this. Oh, let that be a lesson to you, by the way. Draw lines when you have a chance. I may go in there and draw another line, straighten those up. I don't really like those much now that I'm looking at them from over the top. Sometimes you can't get a really good view of it until you look from over the top. I think I'm gonna straighten those lines out a little bit. But I'm gonna do that, then I'll come back. I'll spray it off camera, come back on camera, and sand it off. We'll see what we got. Guys, let's see what it looks like. I like it. Those straight lines were a little tricky. Let that be a lesson to you guys. I tried to do that without drawing lines, and it didn't work out too well. I had to go back and... All right, let's put some clear on it. See if I can do this without messing it up. I'll do the back off camera. I normally would do the back as well, but... Here comes the wind.
Very cute.
I like it. So, as we speak, this is on the way to... Probably on the way to one of you guys that tuned in on Friday night, because we're giving this away. It's Wednesday as we speak, but we're going to plan on giving this away on Wednesday, on Friday, excuse me. Anyway, hope you guys, I really don't like oak. I love the final product. That's the word I'm looking for. I love the final product, but... And oak is just not one of my favorites. Unless your bits are super sharp, it's just really hard to carve. Anyway, it's very consistent, but I love this, love the way it came out. So anyway, if you guys are interested in the creepy font, then just email Vicky, Vicky with Dave Signs at gmail.com. Huh?
Or call.
Yeah, call 928-565-4566. I normally don't give that over the... It doesn't matter. Everybody knows it. So that's it, guys. I know this probably went long. I'm gonna speed up some of it because it was just a lot. So if we can do anything for you, there's the website. If you have any questions, please email me directly, eric@makeawoodsign.com. And we love you guys. We'll see you on the next one. Bye-bye.